Web 3.0, decentralized internet, artificial intelligence web, semantic web. What do they mean? You'll find the answer to this question in this video. Web 3.0, we've been hearing a lot about it lately. In 25 December 1990, Tim Berners-Lee, who is a pioneer of English physics and the internet, was planning today when he was creating the world's first web browser named Inquire in CERN. So, what does Web 3.0, which was planned by Berners-Lee, mean? In order to understand Web 3.0, we need to understand what Web 1.0 and Web 2.0 are. Web, which the name of it is hidden in, World Wide Web, is one of the services on the internet. Documents containing writings, graphics, pictures, voices, or videos on the internet are transmitted to other computers that are far away. In 25 December 1990, Tim Berners-Lee, who is a pioneer of English physics and the internet, created the world's first web browser named Inquire in CERN. You can visit this site through the link I will leave in the description box and make a nostalgic tour. The creator of the web, Tim Berners-Lee, is trying to guide numerous projects with World Wide Web Foundation that he established in 2009. He describes people as digital citizens and wants them to support themselves by signing the web contract in the Web Foundation site. The contract supports the idea that it is a fundamental right for all humans to have internet access for a lifetime. Here's a section of Tim Berners-Lee's old statements concerning the internet.
There are lots of new things ready to be designed. Really, you have to think about the web technology at the moment and the use we are using it as being the tip of a very large iceberg. Okay, when the first internet messages were sent, or the first email messages, some people may have thought, wow, we have changed the world now. You can send a message across the world just by typing it, and it arrives before you can read it out loud. And so now, how will the world be different? As though there's been a sea change, and now we're going to settle down to a stable life in our new world. Wrong. The pace of change is increasing. It's not getting any slower. This, the web has happened, but it's one step. The web itself is it's part of the plan. We've got the data web, which we haven't got out there yet, and that's going to have very dramatic effects. Going to make us much more powerful in the things that we do. There are going to be a lot more things built on top of the web. There are going to be layers and layers on top of the web. And all the time, computers are getting more powerful. People are becoming connected together, the world being smaller. So there is very little time for sitting back and thinking, oh, look what we did.
This technology, which is led by Tim Berners-Lee, has reached an enormous growth. And for the traffic volume, the world's best 50 websites goes like this. After analyzing the history of web, I want to explain Web 1.0. In Web 1.0, there is a system which interlocks information on computers that are apart. Only specific websites are available in here. Shortly, users take the given information, meaning they consume it. In this system, where servers are necessary, static pages occur and one-way information flow exists. It is safe to say that more than 3 billion people are using the internet with Web 2.0 today, and we get in touch with you the same way right now. In addition to reading, users get to be producers in Web 2.0. In here, user-generated content exists. The place for service is now replaced with platforms, where we can reply to what we read and publish what we want. And the place for static websites is replaced with dynamic websites like browsers such as Google Chrome, advanced browsers, Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. Thanks to Web 3.0, which can also be described as semantic web or decentralized web or artificial intelligence web, we can connect to the internet without any intermediary platforms. In here, peer-to-peer flow of information is provided. This is very similar to banks being off the table in blockchain. In here, centralized servers are off the table. Apart from this, the apps in Web 2.0 are being replaced with the apps in Web 3.0. By this means, decentralization and information privacy is provided. Dear Trade War subscribers, we've learned about the Web 3.0 in this video. We'll learn more about blockchain technology related subjects in the following videos. Don't forget to comment your questions and opinions about Web 3.0. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.